What is Uniswap? How is it different from traditional cryptocurrency exchanges? And what is this Uni token that's been rocketing up the price chart? Well, stick around. Here on Crypto Whiteboard Tuesday, we'll answer these questions and more. Hi, I'm Nate Martin from 99bitcoins.com, and welcome to Crypto Whiteboard Tuesday, where we take complex cryptocurrency topics, break them down, and translate them into plain English. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell so you'll immediately get notified when a new video comes out. Today's topic is Uniswap and the Uni token. It's important to note that this is an advanced topic that relies on prior knowledge of how cryptocurrencies work. If you're new to crypto, you may want to check out additional videos that we'll mention and link to in the description to get you up to speed. Now, let's get started. Uniswap is a decentralized, permissionless exchange that allows anyone to trade Ethereum ERC-20 tokens directly without the use of a middleman. Okay. What exactly did I just say? Don't worry, we're going to work through this together. To understand what makes Uniswap different, let's start out by taking a look at how a traditional cryptocurrency exchange like Kraken or Bitstamp works. To begin with, traditional exchanges are centralized, meaning they are owned by a company that has complete control over the exchange and the computers that run it. Traditional exchanges are also regulated by KYC laws, which is an abbreviation for Know Your Customer. These laws require each new customer to provide extensive personal information, including your home address and tax ID numbers, before you can begin trading on the exchange. Additionally, in order to trade on a traditional exchange, users need to deposit money on the exchange, basically giving the exchange control over their funds. On a traditional exchange, when users want to buy or sell a certain cryptocurrency, they submit a buy or sell order. All of these orders are recorded in the exchange's order book. Once there's a match between a buyer and a seller, a trade is conducted. So this is how a traditional centralized exchange works. If you want to learn more about exchanges and trading, you can check out our What is Bitcoin Trading video, which we'll link to below. Now, let's talk about decentralized exchanges, also known as DEXs. DEXs are part of the decentralized finance ecosystem. Decentralized finance, or DeFi for short, is a term given to traditional financial services such as exchanges, lending services, and insurance that have been decentralized through the use of blockchain technology. If you're not familiar with DeFi or blockchain technology, you can also check out these two videos. We'll leave the links in the description. Now, unlike a traditional exchange that requires a controlling company and centralized servers to operate, a DEX consists of a set of smart contracts deployed on a blockchain. In simple terms, it's a set of automated rules that are executed by a network of independent computers without any central entity controlling it. And if you want to learn more about smart contracts and how they work, you can take a look at our What is Ethereum video. Since DEXs aren't controlled by anyone, they can't be regulated and are in fact open to everyone. When using a DEX, there's no need to open an account or go through an identification process where you'd have to supply your personal information. Additionally, DEXs allow users to trade directly from their own wallets, allowing them to keep full control over their funds. A key difference a DEX has from a traditional exchange is in the way transactions are conducted and how price is determined. As I've mentioned earlier, in a traditional exchange, buyers and sellers set their price expectations as buy and sell orders inside the order book. The more buyers and sellers an exchange has, the larger its order book, and the more liquid the exchange is said to be. In other words, it's easier to find a buyer and a seller that agree on a price and make a trade. Now, imagine there are only two buyers and two sellers on a certain exchange. It would be very hard for any trade to get executed since it's unlikely to find two people who would agree on a price. Without liquidity, the exchange is practically dead since no trades can be conducted. It's the same as having a shopping mall with very few stores or customers. There's just not a lot of business that will be done there. In fact, liquidity is such an important criteria to determine the quality of an exchange that some exchanges use external services called market makers that are willing to buy and sell at all times, creating constant liquidity for the exchange. DEXs, on the other hand, don't store any user funds and have no order book. Liquidity on DEXs is created through liquidity pools. Liquidity pools are a shared pot of funds deposited by the general public, and DEXs use liquidity pools in order to fulfill buy and sell orders. People who deposit funds in liquidity pools are known as liquidity providers, or LPs. In exchange for the locked funds, LPs receive a part of the DEX's trading fees in a process known as liquidity mining. Now that we've covered the differences in how liquidity is provided between traditional and decentralized exchanges, let's talk about how the price of a certain coin is determined. On a traditional exchange, when a seller and buyer reach an agreement through matching orders on the exchange order book, a trade is conducted. At that point, the price of the coin is determined until another trade is executed at a different price. In other words, the price of the most recent trade is considered the current price on the exchange. A decentralized exchange, on the other hand, doesn't have an order book. Users don't trade with one another, they trade within a liquidity pool. And instead of using the last trade to determine the price, a mathematical formula is used. This formula, or algorithm, is called an automated market maker, or AMM for short. Uniswap uses an AMM called Constant Product Market Maker Model to determine the price of coins on its exchange. This AMM follows a simple formula of X times Y equals K. This means that when trading, for example, Ether for DAI, the amount of Ether available times the amount of DAI available on Uniswap's Ether DAI liquidity pool should always equal a constant number. Now, let's break this down a little bit further. Imagine there are 10 Ether and 10,000 DAI on a certain liquidity pool. As we can see, using the AMM model, this means that the number of Ether times the number of DAI would equal 100,000. This is our constant, K. Now, if I were to buy one Ether, this would reduce the number of Ether in the pool to 9. Now the question remains, how many DAI will this cost? Well, the way to calculate this is to take our constant of 100,000 and divide it by the new number of Ether, which would be 9. This would give us the new number of DAI required in our pool, which would be 11,111, meaning we would need to deposit around 1,111 DAI to buy one Ether. As you can see, the price is determined by how much of a certain token you want to buy, and not by how much someone else wants to get for it. By using the constant product market maker model algorithm, liquidity is kept without the need for external market makers, no matter how large the order size or how tiny the liquidity pool. This model makes it infinitely expensive to consume the whole amount of a certain coin, putting a damper on larger orders. For example, in our previous exercise, if I wanted to buy 9 Ether, it would cost me 90,000 DAI to maintain the 100,000 constant, making each Ether cost 10,000 DAI instead of the just over 1,100 DAI it would cost to buy only one Ether. Of course, there are other DEXs with different AMM algorithms than the one used in Uniswap, but that's a conversation that goes beyond the scope of this video. Now that we've covered DEXs, we can focus on Uniswap more in depth. Uniswap is a DEX built on top of the Ethereum network infrastructure. It's a set of automated rules used for trading ERC-20 tokens, which is a term given to a certain standard of Ethereum tokens. Uniswap is the most popular decentralized application, or dApp, on the Ethereum platform, with hundreds of thousands of users trading on it each week. Additionally, Uniswap is one of the most forked projects in the DeFi space, meaning people use its code to build additional applications. The first version of Uniswap started out in November of 2018. Uniswap's V1 allowed trading of any ERC-20 token to Ether and back. In May of 2020, V2 was released, and the trading of ERC-20 tokens directly between one another without first having to trade with Ether became available. In May of 2021, V3 was released, allowing a more effective use of capital to whoever decides to supply liquidity to Uniswap. In other words, you can squeeze more juice out of the money you deposit in the liquidity pool. Trading also got more efficient, lowering trading costs compared to V2. Additional changes, which we won't go into in this video, include concentrated liquidity, active liquidity, range orders, flexible fees, and more. So, how do you actually use Uniswap? Well, it's fairly simple. All you need is an Ethereum wallet like MetaMask, which can interact with other Ethereum applications. Once you have MetaMask installed on your browser, head over to uniswap.org, click on Connect Wallet, choose MetaMask, and now you can start trading any Ethereum ERC-20 token that is listed. Keep in mind that since there are many people conducting trades on Uniswap simultaneously, the price shown when you place your order may be different from the actual price when the order is executed. This phenomenon is called slippage, and you're able to cap how much slippage you're willing to tolerate before canceling your order. The reason for slippage is that every trade on Uniswap is actually an Ethereum transaction, and it can take some time to broadcast the transaction and get it confirmed by the Ethereum network. By the time the transaction is confirmed, the price may have already changed. Due to its decentralized and non-regulated nature, Uniswap supports many types of ERC-20 tokens. In fact, practically anyone can create their own token and list it on Uniswap for free, filling Uniswap with a wide variety of tokens, but unfortunately, a fair number of scam coins as well. Just because a coin is listed on Uniswap doesn't mean it's legit or has any intrinsic value. As opposed to a traditional exchange that does extensive due diligence and research on every coin it adds to its platform, Uniswap doesn't. So it's up to you to do your own research, as they say, and decide if you want to invest in a certain coin. Finally, let's talk about the UNI token, a coin that has gradually made its way to the list of top cryptocurrencies. In September of 2020, Uniswap introduced the UNI token through an airdrop, meaning each person who previously used Uniswap received 400 UNI tokens for free. Even though the UNI token has risen substantially in value since its release, it wasn't designed to serve as a currency. It's actually a governance token, allowing whoever holds it to influence and vote on development decisions. The more tokens you hold, the more voting power you have. The idea is for the Uniswap team to gradually fade out their involvement in Uniswap and leave the management of the project to the token holders. So, how is it that a token that wasn't meant to have any value rose to the top of the cryptocurrency list? Well, it seems that the price of UNI represents how valuable people believe that Uniswap will be in the future, and therefore are willing to pay to be a part of its governing body. In the cryptocurrency space, it's not uncommon for coins that never had any intention of being used as a financial asset to become very valuable. In the end, it's up to you to decide if being part of the Uniswap governing body is worth the price of the UNI token. That's it for today's episode of Crypto Whiteboard Tuesday. Hopefully by now you understand what Uniswap is, a decentralized exchange that allows users to trade any ERC-20 token without any intermediary. You may still have some questions. If so, just leave them in the comment section. Finally, if you're watching this video on YouTube and enjoy what you've seen, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and click that bell so you'll be notified as soon as we post new episodes. It really helps us out a lot. Thanks for joining me here at the whiteboard. For 99bitcoins.com, I'm Nate Martin, and I'll see you in a bit. Go through an identification process where you'd have to supply your 90,000 DAI to maintain the one. Nope. Let's try that again. The constant product market maker model. So we can focus on Uniswap more. Uniswap, no matter how large the order.